Let us study the DNA fingerprinting. DNA fingerprinting is the technique which helps to identify the person based on the uniqueness of DNA sequence. Okay, we are using DNA fingerprinting to identify the person based on their uniqueness of DNA sequence. Alec Jeffrey in 1985 first used this technique. Alec Jeffrey was the first person to use this technique in the year 1985. It works on the principle of VNTR. VNTR is nothing but variable number tandem repeats. About 99.9% of our DNA sequence is same. Only 0.1% differs from person to person. Okay. It is important to know that there is unusual sequence of bases of 10 to 15 pairs. 10 to 15 pairs of bases. differs. They are unusual and which repeated several times, and they are termed as VNTR, that is variable number tandem repeats. Okay, on this principle only the DNA fingerprinting works. The DNA fingerprinting involves the following steps. That first one is extraction of DNA. Extraction of DNA, the DNA is extracted from the crime spot, taking the blood drop or the hair follicle, whatever the things we get from the crime spot, we are taking it and we are extracting the DNA from the tissue or the blood. Okay, then we are adding the, this is the DNA, we have extracted the DNA. Then we are adding the restriction enzymes to get the DNA fragments of different length based on the patterns of VNTR. Here are the DNA fragments. On restriction, on adding the restriction enzyme, we got the DNA fragments. Now we are adding these DNA fragments to the electrophoretic suppression. Okay, here what happens, it is electrophoric separation is nothing but the gel electrophoresis. We are adding these fragments into the gel electrophoresis to get separated on the basis of their length by adding the electrophoretic gel electrophoresis. Okay, here the fragments get separated according to their length. Now, next step is southern blotting. Here, the double-strand DNA fragments on the gel sheets are treated with an alkali solution to split in them into a single strand. The bands of the single-stranded DNA are transformed from the gel slab to a nitrocellulose sheet. This method is called as southern blotting. Okay. Here in southern blotting, we are treating these DNA fragments with the alkali solution so that the DNA fragments get separated, the double bonded DNA gets separated into single bonded DNA. Then we are transferring those DNA into nitrocellulose sheet. Okay, nitrocellulose sheet. This technique is known as southern blotting. Then we are treating it with a radioactive probe. DNA on the nitrocellulose sheet is treated with a radioactive DNA probe. DNA probe here is nothing but the short single-stranded DNA segment which is perfectly bound to a specific complementary single-strand DNA fragment on the sheet. Then the next step is autoradiography, which is the last step. Here the nitro sheet is X-ray photographed. Only such bands to which the radioactive bands appear on the dark spots or the in the banded form. This is known as autoradiography. Then after autoradiography, we are comparing the DNA bands Okay, the DNA bands obtained from the spot, as well as we are comparing it with a suspect. Okay, this, we are comparing it with a suspect.